As we're learning about the broader topic of thermodynamics, let's talk about the quantity of internal energy. And so the first thing that we've got to do in any thermodynamics problem, when we're talking about the movement of heat, which is thermos and dynamics, that's where we're coming from, movement of heat, we have to carefully define a system that we're going to use as our reference point. So the system is the only thing that we care about. And so when energy goes into a system, it's greater than zero. And if energy turns around and leaves a system, we're going to say that that energy change is negative. Okay, and so everything else other than the system is defined as the surroundings, and the surroundings encompass everything that is not within the system. So defining our system is going to be very important. We have to make sure we know what the system is in every single problem that we do. Now, internal energy, or rather in our discussion, we're looking at the change in internal energy. So this capital delta symbol means change in. And really, anytime you see that change in, it means the final state minus the initial state. Okay, so that delta just adds final minus initial to any quantity that it precedes. And so for thermodynamics, one of the more important equations is being able to determine the change in internal energy as the sum of heat energy change plus the sum of work done on or by the system. Okay, and so let's reconsider our system for a moment. If heat energy goes in to a system, we're going to consider that change to be greater than zero, so the number will be positive. Likewise, if heat leaves, the change in heat energy will be less than zero. Okay, and so if the system gets warmer, we've added heat, that's positive. If the system loses energy, then it's going to be negative. Work. If work is done on the system by the surroundings, that's going to be greater than zero as well. And then if the system does work, anytime you do work, you get tired because you lose energy. The system's no different. The system loses energy when it does work. So we'll consider that to be a negative change in energy. Okay? And so this being able to interpret this diagram is going to be very important. Okay, another thing we have to consider is the first law of thermodynamics. And so that's where we get the basis of this positive and negative from, is that heat that is gained or lost by the system will be equal to the negative of heat gained or lost by the surroundings. And so what that means is energy cannot be created nor destroyed. It's rather transferred. So the heat energy can only be transferred from one to the other. So if the system has positive heat, then the surroundings is going to have negative heat. Likewise, if the system is losing heat, that's a negative times a negative. That means the surroundings gains heat. So this is, if system gains, the surroundings lose. And if the system loses heat energy, the surroundings will gain energy, because negative times a negative gives us a positive. And so the best thing to do is examples for this. Okay, so if we read a problem, 5 joules of heat is transferred from the surroundings to the system. While the system does 5 joules of work, what is the net change in internal energy? So we have to decide for our net change whether Q plus W is positive or negative for each individual quantity. So if we go from surroundings into the system is going to gain energy, so Q is going to be positive. And work, the system does the work, Suppose the system lifts something, suppose the system has to push something a certain distance. Force times distance is another, is energy as well, the units for work and the formula for work. And so that means the system, since it's doing the work, it's going to lose energy. Okay, and so we could say negative for W. So we plug those numbers in, we get positive 5 plus a negative, so minus 5 as well, and we get 0 as the net change. And so to keep our units the same, 0 joules of change. Okay, what about if we have a problem where 500 joules of heat is transferred, and so we're not really telling us which way it's going directly? Write our formula down. Resulting in a temperature drop in the system. So that tells us that heat is leaving the system and going into the surroundings, and we have to define our heat and work transfer by the system. That's why we define it carefully, so it's our reference point. We don't care about the surroundings in these types of problems, other than their relationship to the system. So negative Q is a temperature drop. 5 kilojoules of work is done on the system by the surroundings. So the surroundings are doing the work. That means energy is going into the system as a quantity from work. So let's put everything together. So 500 joules, the point there holds 3 significant figures in place, and it's negative because we are losing heat. And then 5 kilojoules is going in from work. Now we've got to be careful here because we've got units that don't match. All right, and so we know how to convert with conversion factors at this point, so we need to do that here. And so we could say 500 joules. What do we want to get rid of? We want to get rid of joules. We want to get kilojoules. What are 2 equal quantities? So we're only multiplying by 1. Well, there's 1,000 joules in 1 kilojoule. That's what the K means, is 1,000 times a joule. And so we end up with 0.500 to 3 significant figures, and we convert to kilojoules. And we've got to be careful, what does the problem ask for? Does it ask for kilojoules, or does it ask for joules? Well, it doesn't say in this problem, but it might on a future problem. So be careful and look for that. So negative 0.5 kilojoules plus 5 kilojoules is going to be to 3 significant figures. Well, now we have to be careful, though, because we're doing addition and subtraction. So we can only go to the hundredths place, because we only go to the hundredths place here. Okay, it's not like multiplication where we take all 3 significant figures. 1,000 has an unlimited number of significant figures because it's a definition. So here we get 4.50 kilojoules is the net change, and that's a positive change in energy for the system.